Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. It is Wednesday, so that means we are going to be looking ahead to the next day or so in FIFA Ultimate Team with the rewards market. We're going to take a step back from the Black Friday conversation just for a day, and we're going to take a look at what is going on with the rewards situation this week. Can we make coins from Thursday flipping? We're going to talk about, since the market is so low, since a lot of people have sold stuff off, even though it started to rebound a little bit, are we going to see a higher rebound on Thursday, which I think we are going to see for a number of reasons. So we're going to take a look at today at some of the cards you might be able to buy, some movements around rewards that might be a little bit more risky, a little more safe, stuff around those lines, possibly also when to buy Road to the Final Set 2 cards. We've already started to see Road to the Final Set 1s bounce up a little bit out of packs. I think that could happen with Road to the Final Set 2 as well, since Champions League games are next week. So that's going to be somewhere where we put some attention towards this as well. First things first, I want to take a look at what is happening today. This is a Team of the Week prediction. Of course, it's not the actual Team of the Week, but just a couple cards. This looks pretty decent for a Team of the Week, if I'm being honest. Osimhen with the ones to watch upgrade. This prediction actually has Varane in for Team of the Week as well. That could be very interesting. Alderweireld. Now, again, these are all cards and informs from international break, so there probably won't be dynamic images. This prediction has Werner in. A lot of people have put in Goretzka over Werner, but Mane, Mahrez, Wijnaldum for sure getting in. Eriksen possibly getting in as well. Vidal as a once to watch item. And then a Hero Teixeira card is very possible. That could be very interesting for this market as well. I would be very careful with the Rule Breakers Teixeira. Because of this card coming out with the pace, that might be, we might have sort of a situation where we have with Llorente last week where a Rule Breaker drops because an inform comes out that would be a lot cheaper. So we'll talk about that situation maybe a little bit too. But this is the possible Team of the Week for today. Of course, if you're watching this video after 6 p.m. UK, it is already out. But we could see some market movements, especially because of this Timo Werner, and we already are. So some people are expecting Timo Werner to get a left wing inform possibly today in the game, and what that is causing is a little bit of panic selling. And this is my first little tip, and something that I'm going to be watching very closely in the next 12 hours or so is this Timo Werner inform card. Now right now it looks like he's rebounded back up a little bit. He was just 290k, he's back to 303, so it looks like the panic selling and some of the listing is coming in spurts, because people are thinking that since this guy is in Team of the Week predictions, that he might end up getting a Team of the Week, and some people are selling their inform Werners because of that. Now, do I think that's a good idea? No, I do not think that's a good idea, because this card last week before it dropped off was 375,000 coins. He is an inform striker in the Premier League. Very good card, very popular card because of the pace, right? Now, if Timo Werner gets an inform this week, it's probably going to be a left wing, right? A left wing Timo Werner would not be as, it's got a four-star weak, he's got a four-star weak foot, so he could be usable out there on the left wing. But I think people would value the striker card still, even if we get an 87 Werner. The left wing card, I feel like if there's panic selling on the striker Werner, it would pop back up in price because we have so many other left wings in this game already. So that's something to watch out for. And of course, if he doesn't get in, if Goretzka gets in, which is kind of who I think might get in, I'm just watching the panic selling on this card because he hasn't really risen up like the rest of the market is or has. And if he drops a little bit more today, he doesn't get in Team of the Week, or Goretzka gets in, then I might expect this card to kind of bounce up out of packs. So that's kind of one specific situation that I wanted to talk about. But for Thursday flipping for the rest of the week this week, what are we really looking at? And what is the situation and the concept this week with Thursday flipping? What's going on, right? So a lot of people obviously can see that prices on the market have gone down, right? Pogba 895 is getting pretty low. But a lot of these out of packs special cards have gotten really low because people have sold cards ahead of Black Friday, and that's what they're kind of planning ahead for. Now, this week, what's going to make people want to buy cards for Weekend League? Well, of course, just playing the actual Weekend League, they're going to want to buy cards. Some people might not spend as many coins, but I think there might be less people this week that are invested or thinking about Thursday flipping investments because they think the market isn't going to rise. Well, it's a weekend, right? Now, that Laporte is getting pretty cheap, 470, if that's a real price. People are always going to buy cards for Weekend League, especially if it is on the casual sort of like FIFA player base. The casual FIFA player base is always going to be buying cards for Weekend League. 465 This guy was 490 multiple times yesterday. If we look at the flipping graph, I actually might be buying this as a little Thursday flip investment a little early. So he hit 460, hit 452 at a very low point. I'm going to keep watching this card because this is definitely going to go back up. But this would be a perfect Thursday flipping opportunity, in my opinion, right here already. We're seeing these cards get undercut a little bit. You can honestly flip these on the hourly graph, right? Like this guy goes to 490K multiple times in a day. And right now he's 460, right? So there's a little bit of profit margin in there. But this could be something you kind of look for a Thursday flip this week, is just watch a little bit of a sell-off or a little bit of a down on a fluctuation on one of these rule breaker cards, because the rule breaker cards are so rare in this game. They are very rare, but they're also very desired. You know, guys like Douglas Costa, if Goretzka gets an inform today, then possibly you see that Douglas Costa go up. You know, Llorente, Andre, Kamara, some of the other rule breaker cards fluctuate a lot. So that would be one place where I would kind of look at this week as a possible scenario for where you could buy some cards and make some coins off of that flip. Now I'm going to wait to buy this Llorente because there's three cards here within 5 minutes that are around the same price. See if we maybe get a bit of an undercut on that one. But this is basically what I would do this week for Thursday flipping. I would scroll through these team of the weeks, right? And look for cards that really haven't risen up that much yet, or ones to watches that really haven't risen up that much yet. Firmino was 199,000 coins at his absolute lowest on the weekend. He's still 207. Brazilian, striker, Premier League. This type of card, since this week, a lot of people are invested in SBC fodder as well. A lot of people are already invested in stuff. They can't go out and buy Thursday flips. So that is less people going to invest in cards to artificially inflate them before rewards. I still think there's going to be demand this week because people always buy cards for weekend league. There's always some sort of demand as we head into the weekend. Now, a lot of weeks, it just depends on if there's overinvesting and if people have bought up cards already. So this week, when you're looking to buy items, you're definitely going to want to stick to like what's hot, right? Like think about this week's team of the week. If there's any link investments to this week's team of the week, that might be something to keep your eye on. You know, like a Wijnaldum. Again, Firmino for the Wijnaldum would be a great shout, of course, right? Because Wijnaldum is almost not quite guaranteed to be in, but it's pretty much guaranteed to be in because of his two-goal performance from the midfield. And if this Firmino card gets really close to 200,000 coins again, that was his lowest. It's a very rare inform from team of the week 3 or 5, whatever team of the week he was from. This would be a card that I would keep a close watch on today, right? Out of packs informs are going to be the place where I look, I think, today, just because it requires less demand for them to rise because there's less supply on the market. But the gold cards are probably going to do pretty well this week too, right? Just meta gold cards. I'm definitely going to be curious to see what happens with some of these meta golds that have risen up a little bit already. I want to see if they get panic sold at all. I feel like they just have to rise a little bit more. You know, guys like Hyunmin Son. Son was like 85,000 coins on Sunday night, and right now he is 97K, so he's up a decent amount. Now, I might be a little bit hesitant on a guy like this, but if he's just meta like that, he probably continues to go higher. Somebody who I might be interested in, though, is like Paul Pogba. Paul Pogba right now, I think, is 165 on the market, which is still kind of where he's been at. I think he was close to 150 at one point earlier this week. So if you saw any of these really meta gold cards drop maybe like 10%, if you see any sort of a 10% drop on a Mendy, he's actually down a bit, on a Gomez, on a Martial, Rashford, you know, Pogba would be one of those. Timo Werner's gold card, if he does get in team of the week, could be interesting. Wijnaldum has been invested in a little bit. Firmino would be a gold card that you could buy up. Even a KDB would be somebody. Usman, possibly. Of course, the lower rated guys could get supplied a little bit at rewards, and you see those prices move then. But that's kind of where I'm looking this week, boys. Mostly focusing on the out of pack stuff, like we normally do every week. But just knowing what stuff is meta and what kind of stuff you can find a low fluctuation on. Jamie Vardy at 165. I'm pretty sure that's low. He was 165 on Sunday or Monday, 164, 163. He had a peak of 173 yesterday. What about Monday? He was in the 155 range at his absolute lowest. So like, I would try to get this at 160 if you could. That doesn't seem too terrible for me as a flip this week. So just keep an eye out on some of that stuff. I don't think it's going to be a crazy week in terms of profits because some people are still rocking untradeable teams and, you know, they are a little bit scared of the Black Friday promotion that is upcoming. But I think a lot of people are still going to kind of treat it as a weekend league where they say, hey, I can buy this Pogba for a pretty cheap price. Maybe I sell him after the weekend. Maybe he does go back down a little bit after that. But I think we'll see a decent market rise at rewards. Now let's talk about some ones to watches, because that is happening today as well with the new team of the week, right? This ones to watch, Arturo Vidal, all right? We were live streaming tonight on twitch.tv. Link is down below in the description. And I asked the chat because I wanted to see what their opinion was on this card. I said, yo guys, what do you think this card's price will be if he gets an 85 rated in form? What do you think his price will be? And a lot of them made really great points. And we were talking about this together. The 85 or 86 rated Milinkovic-Savic in form on this game, right now, 86 rated Milinkovic-Savic, which is a very similar card to what this would be with an upgrade, is 60,000 coins. And he was 40,000 coins while he was in packs. So what makes you think that this Vidal card is anywhere near worth the current price that he is right now? Maybe a little bit better links with some interlinks, of course. True. But if you have this once to watch Vidal card, I would take the cash. He has more than doubled. He was 30,000 coins before he had the 2-goal performance. I think this card's going to drop down once he gets the once to watch upgrade and goes to an 85. So if you can cash that at 90K, be my guest. One other card that I would probably cash out as well would be this Hakimi wants to watch card. He is up from 20,000 coins. He's about to be 30K, I believe. And I would just take the coins here as well. I know that he could be a link up. It might be a nice link from, you know, Vidal to Hakimi with both of those inter cards getting informs this week. Actually, Erickson in Team League predictions as well. That's kind of, we might have like, that'd be wild if we had 3 Inter players in Team League. That'd be pretty crazy. But it could happen because it's international break. So, I don't know. Even this one, too. I'm a fan of selling the ones to watch cards in the hype unless it's a huge, super-duper meta player and they weren't really expected to get a Team of the Week and it looks like they're going to get in. So, I'm a fan of selling in the hype on this one as well. Take your profit and go with it. And, of course, the big one, Osimhen as well, is another one that I would probably take the coins on for the same reason as... the same reason as Vidal. If this guy gets an 82 rated inform, or what's Osimhen's rating right now? He is 81, right? He's 82. So he's going to get an 84 rated inform. I don't feel like an 84 rated Osimhen inform is going to be more than 30,000 coins. So, or maybe even like 20, 25K just because of the links. You could be in the money maybe a little bit with this card, just because of the fact that it links to Lozano. This might be one that like shoots up once he gets the 84 rated inform, if he is going to be in Team of the Week, because his upgrade might be pretty saucy. And he's got a 4-star weak foot, but 3-star skills. You know, this one maybe is there, if there's anyone to hold, this would be the one you could give it a shot if you wanted to. But this is the big one that I wanted to talk about. Ferran Torres today was at 90,000 coins on the PlayStation. This is one of the biggest sells I've ever seen, man. This guy is not getting in Team of the Week today. It's literally impossible. Not impossible, but it's very, very rare, and I don't think it ever happens for a player to get an inform on Wednesday for a Tuesday Team of the Week game. So this card going to 90K today was crazy. This is like, I don't know how this guy is so expensive and hasn't got a special card yet. He keeps getting good performances in Champions League and in games where it's like right before Team of the Week drops, so he can't actually get an inform. So it's kind of crazy that this guy has played so well in the recent past, but he still doesn't have an inform yet. And his card, his once to watch item, is 60K. So that one would be a sell if you haven't sold it already, in my opinion. And then once to watch Werner as well, I would probably take the cash, because why is once to watch Werner right now 900,000 coins where his inform is 300,000 coins? A new inform Werner would probably be around like 300,000-350,000 coins, 400K if it's a striker maybe. So I would take the cash here too. I feel like this Werner card, even if he goes up to an 87 today, would drop in price because of that. So that's kind of my feeling with the ones to watches. Now let's talk about the road to the finals, because this is something that, depending on how my Thursday flips go and depending on what I see happen on the market today on Wednesday, which is when I would probably be buying a lot of my flips, I'm going to watch these cards when they get packed during rewards. I do think a lot of these cards are going to drop during the reward supply, kind of like the Team of the Week does. They usually drop for like the first hour or two, maybe three, after rewards, and then they kind of have a kick up in price. They kind of reach a low point and then they bounce back up. And I would definitely watch guys like Promes, Porto, Akanji, and then of course Jesus, Hazard, Sissoko, and Kessie. These guys might be a big buy. If you don't feel comfortable investing in Thursday flips and you want to wait until after, you could wait for some of these cards to get packed if you're going to be awake during the first 2 to 3 hours of rewards and closely watch their prices and wait for that kind of supply to stop and the rebound to happen, because that should happen this week on some of these cards. Now, it's going to be different for each card, like how fast the rebound is. So you're going to have to pick a few and definitely watch the price. But Promez would be one I'd be very, very interested in. He was at 230,000 coins on Monday morning with squad battle rewards. So if he gets back to that price again, I'm getting very interested because he has glowing reviews across this entire game. So just going to watch these cards, and who sent a team of the week today would be in that same situation as well. But again, out of packs in forms, they're fluctuating a lot. I just bought a Mertens at 498 and sold it for 535 or 537. So these cards are fluctuating, right? And people are on the game. People are buying cards. It doesn't feel like the market is in really a stance of like, it's panicking. I don't think we're that close to Black Friday yet that everybody has just stopped what they're doing and they're doing nothing, right? There's still people that have a desire to play weekend league, to score as well as they can with as many wins as they possibly can get in weekend league. So I don't think that there is any reason to not expect a market rise, at least if it's a little bit of a market rise this week. And since there might be less investors, as I pointed out before, that can make it even better and even more profitable of a market rise. So that's kind of my thoughts on Thursday flipping investments this week. And if you do want to buy any of those road to the finals, I think your time to do it is during that rewards time frame today. I guess there could be a little bit of panic on Friday with whatever content comes out, but I feel like they would rise until that point after rewards. So just kind of think about that. Since people have already started to see the set one of road to the final cards dip, go up in price out of packs, I feel like that's going to make them want to invest in set two and watch those cards go up out of packs as well, because they think they will have the same sort of market rise with Champions League next week. So that's kind of my thoughts on the market right now. We'll talk more Black Friday stuff tomorrow in the uploads on Thursday for sure. But good luck with your rewards. If you are investing, let me know down in the comments what you think. Of course, I always tweet out on Thursdays, hey, how are your rewards? How are your investments? I love seeing you guys interact with the Twitter. That link is down below in the description as well. If you enjoyed it today, again, smash a thumbs up, comment down below, I already said that, and subscribe to the channel if you're new. It's been Nate the Foot Accountant. Catch you guys later. Peace.